My name is Carlos Duarte. I'm a professor of marine science at King Abdullah University of Science and Technology, and I'm honored to also serve as a member of the advisory board for the Red Sea Development Company, who is moving in Saudi Arabia to create new standards in sustainable tourism, not only by observing respect to the environment, but actually demonstrating how in the 21st century, with the right focus, the right scientific basis, and the right principles, it is possible to have a tourism and development for tourism drive a shift and a change in the marine ecosystem towards one of net positive conservation value. I'm also honored to have been recognized with the BBVA Foundation Frontiers of Knowledge Award for Ecology and Conservation Biology. The merits that were recognized in this award are actually contributions that I also bring to the Red Sea Development Company in planning this development for net positive conservation impact. This achievement is the concept of blue carbon, or how the conservation and expansion of mangroves, seagrass, and other components of marine habitats can not only enhance biodiversity, but can also be an instrument in mitigating climate change by locking carbon down into marine sediments, and also help cope with problems such as sea level rise and the effect of storms on vulnerable shorelines. At the Red Sea Development Company, the project is pledging to expand corals and seagrass and mangroves by 30% in an area that is already blessed with a very large amount and extent of these ecosystems, which are in pristine state and very healthy state. So to do that represents a groundbreaking contribution from a development company, and that will be a fundamental underpinning of the strategy towards achieving net conservation value and recovering the lost area of these ecosystems globally. As a scientist, I have been always relatively pessimistic at looking at the loss and observing the loss and reporting the loss of these ecosystems globally. But now I'm turning into a more optimistic overview of the future, because it's not only scientists and scientific projects that can help recover what we lost in the marine environment, but in the 21st century, we hope that many more companies will join the Red Sea Development Company in seeking opportunities to use development as a source of rebuilding marine life and rebuilding, in this case, marine forest, which will also contribute to offset emissions even from travelers that will travel from different destinations to Al-Wash Lagoon, where the Red Sea Development Company is generating their tourism facilities. So the pledge of the Red Sea Development Company that through a development with an attention to the environment, the outcome after the 10-15 years can be better than if this area would have been declared as a protected area, is so far only an intent and a design. And it will take a few years, 5 to 10 years, to demonstrate and showcase how embedding new concepts of biological conservation into development programs, we can contribute to expand and recover these marine forests globally.